Hi friends, welcome you all to this my lecture 11, which is about constant mesh gearbox. In previous 10th lecture, I have given explanation about gearbox and also tractive effort and tractive assistance. Okay, so there are so many of types of gearbox which we have in previous video, previous lecture. So on that, one type is constant mesh gearbox. We are going to see about that in this slide. So, all you know, it is an automobile engineering subject. The code is 162-5505, and we are going to see about constant mesh gearbox. It is lecture 11, and myself, I am Arun Pondian, lecturer, mechanical department of James Polytechnic College, Aurangabad, Bihar. Okay, and now we are going to see the content about what. We are going to see in this video. Okay, so first one, we are going to see the definition of constant mesh gearbox. Number two, we are going to see introduction of constant mesh gearbox. Number three, main parts. Number four, construction. Number five, working principle. Number six, different gear ratios. Number seven, advantages. Number eight, application. And number nine, problems solved by constant mesh gearbox. Okay, so we are going to see regarding these topics. These are the content of this video. One by one, we are going to see. The first one is definition. Okay, what is the definition of constant mesh gearbox? Okay, it is a type of transmission in which all or most of the gears are always in mesh with one another. First point, as opposed to a sliding gear transmission in which engagement is obtained by sliding some of the gear along a shaft into mesh. Okay, so always it will be on mesh together, and as opposed to a sliding gear transmission. This is the one definition. And the second one is okay, so we have seen the definition of constant mesh gearbox. Now we are going to see the introduction of constant mesh gearbox. Okay, we are going to see one by one. I will read it and I will explain you. Okay, the first one is, in a constant mesh manual gearbox, gear ratios are selected by small clutches that connected the various gear sets to their shaft so that power is transmitted through them. Okay, so in a manual gearbox, the gear ratio selected by the small clutches, small clutch, there will be small clutches, by that only the gear ratios are selected. Okay, and number two, all the gears are always in mesh, and this constant mesh gearbox was invented to overcome the limitation of the sliding mesh gearbox. In this gearbox, all the gears are always in mesh, it will be always in mesh only. Okay, the gear remains fixed and not slide like the sliding mesh gearbox. The gear will remains fixed. Okay, in this gearbox, the sliding mesh was replaced with constantly meshed pairs of gears, and the new shifting devices named dog clutches were introduced. Okay, so in previous this, if you see, there is a sliding mesh gearbox, but as per the SPD syllabus, we don't have that. So that in that device is not there, what are the problems was there, which is solved by using one component extra. It is named as dog clutches. Okay, the constant mesh gearbox usually comes with 4-speed, 1 reverse manual transmission configuration. Okay, there will be 4 gear, first gear, second, third and fourth gear, and one reverse gear. With this only the constant mesh gearbox will come. Okay, this gearbox has different parts like counter shaft, main shaft, clutch shaft, gears and dog clutch. Okay, that we will see later, we are going to see in forward. So the next one is, gears on the counter shaft are fixed to it and the gears on the main shaft are free to rotate. Okay, the next one, helical and herringbone gears are usually used in this gearbox, so it is quicker than sliding mesh gearbox, which uses spur gears. Okay. In this gearbox, all the gearbox in the main shaft and the counter shaft are always engaged with each other. Different transmission ratio or speed ratio are obtained by using the dog clutch. Last one, dog clutches engage with gears on the main shaft to obtain desired width, speed or torque. Okay. And these are the introduction, same construction also, but some points are removed. Okay. So what are the okay. So next we are going to see the main parts of the constant mesh gear box. Okay. So this is a picture of constant mesh gear box. So you are able to see, I think so. So I'll explain one by one. Okay. The first one is shaft. Okay. There are three types of shaft. One is main shaft. Second one is lay shaft or counter shaft. The third one is clutch shaft. Okay. The main shaft, it is also known as output shaft. What are the output shaft? The another name of output shaft is main shaft. Okay. It is the spring shaft over which the dog clutches along with gears are mounted. Where the dog clutches are mounted along with gears. So the main shaft will be splined. Gear on this shaft are free to rotate. In this shaft, gears are free to rotate. Okay, you can see here the black colors. Okay, this means this shaft are free to rotate. This main shaft is free to rotate with the gears. Okay, the second one is lay shaft or counter shaft. Okay, I will show the shaft, then you can know. Okay, these are the three types of shaft. The second one, if you see here, is the lay shaft. It is an intermediate shaft. It is an intermediate shaft between the main shaft and clutch shaft. This is the clutch shaft and main shaft. Between this, on intermediate shaft, this is also called as a lay shaft only. Sorry. Okay, lay shaft and main shaft. The gears of counter shaft are in constant mesh with the gears of main shaft. Also, the gears of counter or shaft are not free to rotate as they are directly connected to the counter shaft. Okay, disconnected the counter shaft. If you see, this black are not here. Okay, so that it is not, these gears are not free to rotate with the counter shaft. Next one is clutch shaft. Okay, if you see here, this is a clutch shaft. This one is the clutch shaft. It is connected to that, it will start to rotate. Okay, the clutch shaft carries the engine output to the gearbox but act as input for the gearbox. It is also known as input shaft. It is an input shaft. That one is a output shaft. Okay, and next one we are going to see about dog clutch. Okay, if you see here, this is called as dog clutch. The dog clutch couples the lay shaft and main shaft by interference and not by friction, not by it will completely, no, it is not, it is, there is, it will not means clamp each, it is not clamp. Okay, it will be free to have. Dog clutch are used to transmit appropriate gear ratio to the main shaft or output shaft. It is used to transmit the appropriate gear ratio, if it is first gear or second gear or third gear, appropriate gear ratio to the main shaft or output shaft. Okay, so there are usually two dog clutches in constant mesh gearbox as shown on the by circle I have shown here. Okay, the next one is gears. Okay, so there are two type of gear, helical gears and bevel gears. Okay, gears of constant mesh gearbox come in pairs. Always it will come in pairs, 2, 3 like that. Okay, all gears of lay shaft or counter shaft are always paired with gears of main shaft or output shaft. I've shown here the paired gears where it is. I've shown here. Okay, the paired gears of counter shaft, the main shaft provide different gear ratio, which can be transmitted to main shaft by engaging dog clutch with appropriate gear ratio required. There are two type of gears. One is helical gears and another one is bevel gears. Okay. And the next one we are going to see, What is the construction of constant mesh gearbox? Okay, what are the constant, okay, what are the construction of? Number first point is, the output of the engine is carried by clutch shaft. The gear in clutch shaft is in constant mesh with the gear of lay shaft. Number two, there are five gears in lay shaft, one of which is connected to gear of clutch shaft and other four are connected with gears of main shaft. Okay, and all four gears are of different sizes to obtain different gear ratio. Okay, so first gear more torque, less speed. Second gear more torque, less speed. Third gear little bit more speed, less torque. Fourth gear more, then more speed and completely less torque. Okay, an ideal gear is present between the gear of lay shaft and gear of main shaft to form reverse gear. Ideal gear we are using to the reverse gear. Okay, so constant gear mesh gearbox employed helical gear for power transmission. The gears are rigidly fixed in the lay shaft. The gears in output shaft rotates freely without engaging with shaft, thus not transmitting power. The gears in both shaft are always meshed together. Okay, to engage the gears with output shaft, dog clutch is used. Okay, so to compare to the sliding mesh gearbox, in constant mesh gearbox only one part is extra, that is called as dog clutch. So it is used to shift the selector fork moved by gear lever. Okay, sorry. Okay, so you are seeing here, we are going to see the working principle of constant mesh gearbox. First point is, when the dog clutch is engaged with different gears of main shaft, different gear ratios are obtained as gears of main shaft are always paired with the gears of counter shaft to form different gear ratio. Okay, so the working principle, dog clutch is engaged with the different gears. So how it takes to other, same way it will, the gear ratios will be obtained as gears of main shaft are always paired with gears. Okay, and the second point is, if the dog clutch is not in contact, first we have seen that if the dog clutch is engaged, the second one is, if the dog clutch is not in contact with any gear, that does not rotate the main shaft. Okay, if the dog clutch is not in contact, because of in the previous slide we have seen that the main shaft is free with the gear. The gear will not have a contact, it will not clamped with the main shaft. So the gear will be free to move in the main shaft. So if the dog clutch is also not contact with the main shaft, the all the gears will be not rotates. Okay, and the third point is, the main shaft rotates only when one of the dog clutch is engaged. Two dog clutch will be there in the constant mesh gearbox. If one is engaged only, the main shaft will rotate. Okay, and the fourth point, reverse gear is obtained in this gearbox using the same technique that was in sliding gearbox, using the idle gear. Okay, the idle gear only we are using for the reverse gear purpose in constant mesh gearbox. And the fifth point, when the gear lever is pushed, the gear selector fork pushes the dog clutch. The dog clutch engages the gear and the output shaft will take the power to the differential. Okay, so when the when it is fifth gear or to the first gear, whenever it may be, when it is pushed, the total output shaft will get the power from dog clutch and it will transmit to the differential. Okay, so this is the working principle of constant mesh gearbox. If you write this 5 point, that is enough. Five point. If you write it in your mind also, it will be it will remind you what is the next point. By point, if you write it, okay. And the next we are going to see about the different gear ratios in constant mesh gearbox. We are going to see about the different gear ratios. Okay. Number one, if it is on the first gear. Okay. I will read it and I will explain. First gear is obtained in constant mesh gearbox when dog clutch gets engaged by interference with the largest gear of main shaft, which is in constant mesh with smallest gear of main shaft. This gear provides maximum torque and minimum speed to the main shaft. Can you understand? If the dog clutch gets engaged by interference with the largest gear, the main shaft will be bigger, and the mesh which is meshed together, that gear will be smaller. If it is like that, the speed will be less and the torque will be more. Okay, this is for the first gear. If it is on the second gear is obtained when dog clutch gets engaged with second largest gear of main shaft. Okay, there will be each different gears in the main shaft, and there are some in the lay shaft. Okay, between these two connection only we are going to see. So the second largest gear will be there. If the dog clutch mesh with the second largest gear, and if the lay shaft will be the second smallest gear, in this it provides higher speed and lower torque than first gear. Can you understand? I'm not telling the higher speed with the last gear. Comparing to the first gear, it will give the higher speed and the lower torque comparing to the first gear. Okay. Now, if it is on the third gear is obtained when dog clutch engaged with second smallest gear of main shaft, which is in constant mesh with the second largest gear of lay shaft. This gear more speed and less torque than second gear. Same explanation, only the word of then second gear. Okay. Now, if it is on the fourth gear, this gear provides the highest or maximum speed in a vehicle using constant mesh gearbox. This gear is obtained when dog clutch engages with smallest gear of the main shaft. And that is important. In that, until third gear, we have seen the biggest gear. Okay, here, smallest gear of main shaft, which is in constant with the largest gear of lay shaft. Okay, so this will provide you the more speed and less torque comparing to the third gear. Now, if it is in the reverse gear. In this gear, the vehicle goes in reverse direction like sliding mesh gearbox, as an idler gear is also used in constant mesh gearbox between the main shaft gear and lay shaft gear to form reverse gear. Reverse gears is obtained when dog clutch engages with gear in main shaft, which is paired with the idler gear. Okay, so these are the five gears of different gear ratios of constant mesh gearbox. Okay. Now, here in the picture, you are seeing how the first gear will transmit, how the second gear will transmit, how the third gear will transmit, and how the fourth gear will transmit. What are the ratios also? It is shown there. Okay. So now we are going to see the advantages of constant mesh gearbox. Number one, constant mesh gearbox are quicker because helical or herringbone gears can be used in this gearbox instead of spur gears. We can change in the place of helical gear, we can put the spur gear also. So that is a big advantage. And second one, since the gears are engaged by dog clutch, if any damage occurs while engaging the gear, the dog unit members get damaged and not the gear wheels. Okay, by changing the gear, if any damage is happening, First, it affects only the door latch. It will not affect any gear. It is a big advantage of the constant mesh gearbox. And now, what is the application of gearbox? Okay. We are going to see the application of gearbox. Number one, constant mesh gearbox was mainly used in farm trucks, motorbikes and heavy machinery. Not in low. We will use in the heavy machinery only. Okay. And number two, it is also used in cars like Ford Model T. In Ford, we are using the constant mesh gearbox. And last one, constant mesh gearbox was used in motorbikes before the introduction of synchro mesh gearbox in 1928 by General Motors. Okay. Before the introduction of synchro mesh gearbox, the constant mesh gearbox was only used in the bikes also. And what are the problems solved by constant mesh gearbox? Okay. The shifting of gears, very noisy process. Asphalt gears were used, but in constant mesh gearbox, the gear shifting becomes very less noisy. Okay. The noise was reduced. Second one, mesh wear is in continuous rotation. So the meshing of gears can cause breakage of gear teeth. But here, if any breakages, any damage happen, only it affect the dog clutches. And the third one, shifting was not easy task for drivers and requires special skill to change gears. Okay, using double D clutching. Okay, it is a process of driver. Here, any driver, any person can easily shift the gear. And at last, we are here. These are the reference books where I prepared this video. So go through these books. You can get more idea about the constant mesh gearbox. Okay. And at last, we have seen about the definition of constant mesh gearbox, introduction, main parts, construction, working principle, different gear ratios, important it is, and advantages, application, and also problem solved by constant mesh gearbox. Okay. And at last, I would like to thank you all to listening this video. I will meet you on the next lecture 12 with the heading of synchro mesh gearbox. Till then, thank you.